I have already done some extensive testing to figure out in which situation you should buy the crate and in which you should buy the python. And today, I'm going to show you my results. Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Elite Dangerous Without Worth Astronomy. The crate has recently been added into the game, and it is very comparable to the python, so today we're going to take a look at the two ships side by side, and we're going to see in which situations you would pick one over the other, and where they differ. So first, let's start by diving into the stats. First of all, let's have a look at the hardpoint layout. You can see here that the hardpoint layout of the two ships are exactly the same. There can be a little bit of a preference in terms of hardpoint placement. The hardpoint placement of the crate is really, really superb. Very nice grouping, very close together at the center. So grouping on so hardpoints on the ships, well, pretty much identical. Moving on to utility mounts, we can see again, both have four utility slots, so nothing different here. Looking at the corn turtles, it's pretty much the same story. They are exactly the same. There's no difference between the corn turtle loadout on the two ships. And moving on to the optional internals, this is where we see the first small difference between the two, because the crate only has two class 6 optional turtles, where the python has three. So far, a small advantage to the python. So I fitted both the crate and the python with exactly the same loadout. I removed all hardpoints. I made sure there was nothing in the utility mounts. I A-rated everything in the corn internals, and I also left the lightweight alloy in there. For the optional internals, I sold every single module and fitted a 6A shield generator. So now we can begin to compare the stats between the two ships. We can start by looking at the jump range, where we see that the crate has a small advantage. It gets one lightier jumper range, which is due to its lighter mass. If we move on and have a look at the speed, we can see that the crate has a base speed of 278, where the python will only get up to 267. So that's 11 meters a second faster base speed. When you're boosting, you gain almost 40 meters a second extra when you have the crate. The crate has 383 boost, whereas the python has 348. Of course, this is with the current build that I'm using here. If we move over and have a look at the ship defense, we can see that the crate loses a little bit here. The shield hit points that it gets is only 350 compared to the python's 398. And we kind of see the same story when we move down to the armor. Again, armor of the crate, 396 compared to the python's 468. So fewer shield hit points, you can have fewer armor hit points. And furthermore, you can also note the armor rating is lower on the crate, meaning that it is less likely to be able to resist penetration. So you're probably going to take more module damage in the crate than you would in the python if you're taking armor damage. Now, in terms of pricing, the crate is a little bit cheaper than the python. Now, here in Shinra to Deshra, where you do get a 10% discount, you can get the crate for 40.5 million, whereas you're going to pay 50 million for the python. It's also worth noticing that the crate here has the opportunity to fit a fighter hangar, and it also has an additional multi-crew seat. So if you're all about that multi-crew, or you want a fighter hangar, you pretty much have to select the crate. Okay, so now we're going to move out to outside the station and let's begin to do some testing. At first, we're going to do some maneuver testing. We're going to do a quick roll test, which is what we're running here. And we can see that when the ships are stationary and we're doing a roll, they pretty much return at the exact same time to the original position. So not much of a difference here. Now moving over to the pitch rate, we can see I've done this while at half speed so that we get the maximum amount of maneuverability out of our ship. This is I've done to give it a little bit more realistic what you have in a combat situation. And you can see here the crate actually ends up winning this, and I got the same result when I did the test with the two ships stationary. So in terms of maneuverability, rolls pretty much the same, but pitching, the crate has a slight advantage. And now for a quite interesting test. A lot of people are thinking the crate is going to be a good smuggling ship, so I decided to do a quick overheating test to see how quickly the ship should read 80% internal heat. So I throttled both of them up to full throttle, and I turned on silent running. And you can see here as the heat goes up, they actually ended up reaching the 80% within about a second, so that's probably within my measuring errors. So I would say overheating-wise, they are pretty much identical as well. So to sum all this up, in which situation should you get either the two ships? I would recommend, if you're going to do any kind of combat, PvE or PvP, get the crate. You get the same weapon loadout, you get the same core internals, and you get better maneuverability. You are going to lose a little bit of defense, but you'll have to try and make up with that for that using your maneuverability, so you're simply just going to get hit less. However, if you're planning to do any kind of trading, smuggling, mining, passenger missions, or anything like that that requires you to go to a medium-sized station, I would still go with the Python because of that extra internal slot, because you get that slight bit of extra hit point, which might save you, if you're very lucky, in case you get pulled out by a pirate. So I really hope you found today's video informative and useful. If you did, remember to give this video a like down below and subscribe to the channel. And until next time, I will see you guys in space.